ذلك الشيء. من السيستم بالبيتاني ظهور بالمية فلا حتى يعطي الجزية أيضا وهم صاغرون يكتفي من أنه هندو أو كريستيان أو بودست or whosoever you may be you can remain but you will have to submit to the Islamic state to the Khilafah and there you will have to pay the taxes the jizya that is the position but individually you will not be compelled to change your religion that is actually the position of Islam it is usually misunderstood as far as the system is concerned the collective system the social order that if we have power and we want to attain power to change it that is called revolution we are working for Islamic revolution to establish the system of Khilafah sovereignty to Allah and Khilafah for the Muslims that will be the system لا إكراه في الدين قد تبين الرشد من الغي the right path has been distinct has become distinct from the wrong path فمن يكفر بالطاغوت ويؤمن بالله So whoever disowns Tawhid, what is Tawhid? Everything which is rebellious against Allah is Tawhid. Every institution which doesn't accept divine sovereignty and authority is Tawhid. The non-Islamic state is the biggest Tawhid on earth. Tawhid are not only individuals, the systems are Tawhid. Tagha. Tagha, what does it mean? Tagha. When you have transgressed your limits, you are taghi. Tagha means to go beyond the limits. You must be a bondsman to Allah. You should be a servant to Allah. You must obey Allah. You were created for His ibadah. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ If instead of being servant of Allah, you become master. I am the ruler. I have the sovereignty. You are in revolt against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are Tawhid. So you have to deny Tawhid first. And then you should have faith in Allah. You have to say La ilaha first. And then illallah. Denial is first. Affirmation comes after that. The same is the thing here. وَمَنْ يَكْفُرْ بِالطَّاغُوتِ وَيُؤْمِنْ بِاللَّهِ Whosoever denies, declares that he is bari from this taghut and then he believes in Allah. فَقَدْ اسْتَمْسَكَ بِالْعُرْوَةِ الْوُثْقَى So he has grasped in his hand a firm handhold لَنْ فِسَامَ لَهَا which will never give way. وَاللَّهُ سَمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ And Allah is all listening, all doing. اللَّهُ وَلِيُّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا يُخْرِجُهُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ Allah is the protector and helper and guardian. Wali, you know, is a very profound word of Arabic. You can't translate it, can't give its connotation in one word in English. Allah is the protector and the guardian and the supporter of those who have real faith. يخرجهم من الظلمات إلى النور. He keeps them taking out from various shades of darkness into light. ظلمات always you'll find in Quran in plural. There are different shades of darkness. There's shirk, there's kufr, there's nifaq, there is ilhad. So many shades, different shades of darkness. Light is one. And darkness has different shades. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always keeps bringing them out from the shades of the darkness into light. وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَوْلِيَاهُمُ الطَّاغُوتُ As for those who don't believe, who disbelieve, their supporters are the طاغوت. They are the brothers and supporters. There's a mutual support. They are supporting طاغوت and طاغوت is helping them. يُخْرِجُونَهُمْ مِنَ النُّورِ إِلَى الظُّلُمَاتِ And these طاغوت They keep on taking them away from light into different shades of darknesses. This is a process going on side by side. الله ولي الذين آمنوا يخرجهم من الظلمات إلى النور. اللهم ربنا اجعلنا منهم, اللهم ربنا اجعلنا منهم. May Allah include us in these people whose wali is Allah himself. And he takes them out from this different shade of darkness into light. وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَوْلِيَاهُمُ الطَّاغُوتِ يُخْرِجُونَهُمْ مِنَ النُّورِ إِلَى الظُّلُمَاتِ اللهم ربنا لا تجعلنا منهم أولئك أصحاب النار هم فيها خالدون. They are the people of fire and they will remain in that forever. أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِي حَاجَّ إِبْرَاهِيمَ فِي رَبِّهِ. Again the same word, أَلَمْ تَرَ. Did you never ponder about the person الَّذِي حَاجَّ إِبْرَاهِيمَ, who argued with Ibrahim فِي رَبِّهِ, about his Lord, his Rabb. Who is your Rabb? Now this person is Namrud, the king of Iraq at the time of Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam. Namrud was also a title, just as Pharaoh. Faraina, the kings of Misr, of Egypt, they were Faraina. The kings of Babylonia, which we now call Iraq, they were Namarida. So actually Namrud and Pharaoh, they are not names, they are titles. Just as Pharaoh, Namrud. أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِي حَاجَّ إِبْرَاهِيمَ. So as we say, Pharaoh of Moses. So Namrud of Ibrahim, of the time of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam. Hazrat Ibrahim was presented in the court of the king. There this dialogue went on. أَنْ آتَاهُ اللَّهُ الْمُلْكُ. He was arguing about God, about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, about the Rabb of Ibrahim, only because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had gave him the kingship. He became arrogant. He himself claimed to be God. I am the authority. Just as you know the Pharaoh of Egypt had said, أنا ربكم العلا ألا سليمكم مصر. It's not for me the kingdom of Egypt. وهذه الأنهار تجري من تحتي. All this irrigation system is under my control. I will allow water to only those whom I please. It is all under my, in my head, under me. In the same way, he was the master of his country. إِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ رَبِّيَ الَّذِي يُحْيِي وَيُمِيتُ. When Ibrahim said, alayhi salatu wassalam, my Lord is he who gives life and puts death. قَالَ أَنَا أُحْيِي وَأُمِيتُ. He said, I have these powers also. And the tradition goes that he fetched and called two people who had been condemned. They were in the prison. That sentence had been passed on them.